there's a huge migration these days, which means a lot of people from cities are moving towards their villages and small towns. One is fear of COVID-19. Second thing, there are no jobs in any sectors. So is there a solution for this problem? Yes, says Bangalore-based Suvarna. And she has a very interesting collective art initiative, Tamala, which also means an evergreen tree in Sanskrit. Ma'am, tell me what exactly Tamala does.
So Tamala is the evergreen tree. For us, it means the evergreen tree which nurtures all forms of art and traditional craft inherent to our country. That is a vision with which we started this organization in 2015. From there, we have come a long way. Today, we support about 150 artisans across the country in supporting and sustaining their livelihoods. This is done through providing them a marketplace in the city, as well as a lot of upskilling and design improvements that we try to do, keeping in mind the inherent technique and skills that they use. So we work across 41 clusters now across India, and hopefully we'll take our vision forward. I think it is especially relevant in today's times with the pandemic going around and lot of loss of livelihoods in the city as well as the villages. So maybe our best bet to get out of this critical situation is to create more livelihoods, sustain the livelihoods which are inherent to rural India, creating better living conditions and a way of life for our villages that will in fact support the cities too. So that is how we see it today.
So, and you see a lot of positives in terms of the whole things that are happening. I mean, anyway, the virus is for real, but still people are coming back and they want to look for some opportunities also. Yeah. And many people don't know the gifting industry, both the individuals and also the corporate industry, is about 2 lakh crore rupees. It's a huge industry. Many people do not know about it. And also the sad thing is only 5% is of Indian share. So where do you look at the whole scenario? Like, is it an advantage for people like Tamala, given the fact that most of it is coming from China? So now there's a huge talk between China and India, and the relations are really bad.
See, I inherently try to see positives in every situation. So even with the pandemic going berserk everywhere and people are tense, we know, but there are positives in this. What we have been trying to say for 5 years now, that the circular economy is the best way to go forward, is sort of being emphasized by everybody now, and there's a rising wave of supporting Make in India, especially handmade in India, where this is a cultural heritage we have received and it's our duty to support and protect it. Chinese products, yes, our challenges lie in the pricing and the glamour of the Chinese products, but they compete with Indian handcrafts, which are indigenous, and very importantly, again, I will emphasize the livelihoods of artisans that is at stake. And any country's economy is enriched only by supporting its inherent crafts and art. So that is a very important factor. I wish this, it is actually becoming widespread. The feeling of being proud of your country and being proud of what it has to offer in terms of its creativity is something which we probably should have realized a few years back, but I'm very happy that it's happening now.
So festivals are a big thing for Indians. Like, it's like a time to celebrate, and we wear new clothes and we gift each other, relatives, friends and all. And Ganesha Chaturthi is one big festival in Karnataka, Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu and Andhra Pradesh. So I believe that you come out with a unique Ganesha, which is eco-friendly. And tell me more about that.
Yes, I believe India starts its festive season with Ganesh Chaturthi, as all devout Hindus believe that he is the destroyer of all evil. So maybe in this year, Ganesh Chaturthi becomes all the more relevant for Hindus all over. In praying and for a better tomorrow. So Ganesh Chaturthi. So what we do is we also start off our big chain of products and new creations coming up
here,
along with Ganesha.
One beautiful Ganesha,
yes, let me
here.
Show.
Yeah, and such a good features, ma'am, it has.
Yeah, this is made of pure river clay. So that is the one difference which makes it really authentic. And in olden times and from traditionally, we have been celebrating Ganesh Chaturthi with mud idols of Ganesha. It was never a very fancy or, glitzy affair at all. What you do is go to your backyard and collect a fistful of mud and make a Ganesha out of it, and you used to worship that. So we are trying to bring back that tradition itself. So yeah, this is our clay Ganesha made of pure riverbed clay made by rural potters. And as you can see, we do put in a lot of research for the features, and because finally beauty is in the eyes of the beholder, but it should be a universal thing.
And also, how do you get one, ma'am? Because many people, they just go out, go to the market, just see a beautiful POP made Ganeshas, the colorful Ganeshas, just buy it. So how do you market this product?
So basically, this is our fifth year that we'll be doing eco-friendly Ganesha. And as before I said, we've been emphasizing that climate change is real. So this is one more thing. I think COVID has taught us very harshly that we need to be wake up and answer the call. So this is pure clay, pure mud. It dissolves in water in 10 minutes flat, and you have no impurities along with it. So we make sure that we don't add any additives, unlike POP. Now, since you brought up the POP, let me say POP is a synthetic material which does not dissolve in water. It clogs all our lakes and kills all marine life. So I would advise everybody to go for this. There's a small step to take for bringing about the change we need in the climate conditions today.
Yeah. There you are, this is a beautiful Ganesha. Just go to the website tamala.com and just order, and this Ganesha can be, Indian made.
Be delivered to your doorstep.
Indian made.
Yes.
And it's the right time to, buy this.
And the big thing is, each Ganesha you take home lights up our potter's life. So
exactly,
that's the main
thing
for us.
Great favor to the Indian artisans,
yes,
also. Yeah,
yes.
Exactly. So this Ganesha Chaturthi, it's about Vigna Vinashaka. And it means to getting rid of all the obstacles. What is the message on this Ganesha Chaturthi?
That is a very nice message you said. Vigna Vinashaka is the right form of Ganesha to pray for this year, especially every year, but yes, especially so this year. Let all obstacles which we are facing today, outward and inward, dissolve with this coming festival. And let us look inwards, look towards healing ourselves and our environment. So I wish everybody who is watching this a very happy Ganesh Chaturthi. Let it bring calm and peace and happiness to us all.
And thanks, Suvarna. And here from Smart Sustain, we wish everybody a happy Ganesh Chaturthi, and Tamala
wishes you the same.
Same. And thank you very much for speaking to Smart Sustain.
Thank you. Thank you so much.